What's up, YouTube? Hold on. Got a mail call. My buddy Joe Rader. So Joe had some cars for sale at the train show. And he thought they would sell out. And they didn't. No, by the way, a little damage here. Hope it's all in there. We'll see. Good old post office. Gotta love them. Ow! God, knocker. Cut myself. Yep, they're all there. They're all there. Let me take them out of the box. Alrighty, they are scale trains cars, hopper cars to be exact. Joe made me a good deal, couldn't refuse. Canadian Pacific, another Canadian Pacific. Another Canadian Pacific. It's okay. Save the best for last. This is what I really wanted. This Ferromex. This is a cool hopper. Yeah, I want to look at that. Let's look at it together. It's interesting how SkyTrains packages things. When I first saw that, I thought the post office broke them. Beauty. I'm guessing Joe can tell me if he changed these couplers out or not. That's a pretty car, man. That's really nice. Nice job, scale trains. These are operator series. Thank you, Joe. I appreciate it. Everything wounded. Everything got here. Got blood on the car. Nice. Yeah. Well, it's kind of like they hit somebody. But, yeah. Let's take a look at it. I'm going to, in this same video, this one is an operator series. And this is, BNSF Heritage Forward logo. Don't know what that means, but this is a rivet counter. We'll look at them and, oh, that's cool. That's awesome looking. Yeah, that's really nice. I like that. The Denver Road. Yeah. A lot of weight to it. Yeah, we'll pause here and we'll compare the cars and check them out under better lighting conditions. Alrighty, let's compare these cars. Rivet counter, operator. First glance, right away. I see these grab irons up here. They are not on the top of those. Okay. So all this is, you know, does it make a difference to you? I don't know. Is it worth it to you? I don't know. You're going to have to determine operator, rivet counter. Okay. Secondly, there's some decaling differences, and let's just run through the rivet counter. There's some decaling here, right? There's decaling on the hopper bottoms themselves. I think they are vibrators. They hook up vibrators to them. They look applied here. I really What's that say? Trying to read it. I don't know. Can't make out what that says. Can you? It's 1812 cubic feet is what it says in section A, section C, section B. So it tells you what's. So there's more decals on these. Like I said, these look applied. These, whatever these are, vibrators, or I don't know what they are. Roller bearing trucks. See, like the little bearings move. Does it matter to you? I don't know. A little more piping. You see, there's more piping going to the brake reservoir. There's an air hose. See an air hose, a cut lever. The steps that all look the same, just a little more detail. Conspicuity striping, right? Conspicuity striping. Let's look at the operator. So you see here how these look molded in. There's no decal work on the hoppers themselves. No conspicuity striping. No roller bearings, no cut lever, no cut lever. This one's missing a brake wheel, no big deal. No piping inside there, no air hose. I don't know the price difference between these two cars when they come. All right, so. That's the thing. I don't know what they're like, but I really like the I like them both. The Ferromax is what I really wanted. He told me he had two Ferromaxes. Somebody bought one, and that's really what I was interested in. I didn't wasn't really interested in the others, but I didn't know what this was like. This feels heavier. Wish I had a scale. I really like this one. He sent me photos, but he wasn't able to send photos of everything. For some reason, email just wouldn't let him put them all in there. So here is the CP. The rest of them are the same. No conspicuity stripes. Same thing. No cut lever, no air hoses. Everything else pretty much the same, right? No roller bearings. Everything's pretty much the same. Would you notice the only thing that you would really notice on a layout going by? And would you really notice is in this applied grab arm, and you could just get one. They do have the holes there for it. They do, Scaltrains does make a detail kit for the operators. How much the detail kit is, I don't know. So it would, you could probably pick up these grab irons, and in my opinion, the more stuff you have hanging, the fragiler the car is, right? It just is. These stirrups are really nice. They look metal, and they're not crappy like a lot of other people's are. But Scaltrains did an awesome job with these cars, I gotta say. Scaltrains is pretty first class. When Scaltrains does something, it's rocking. I think Scaltrains is setting the bar for other people. Although Atherin's pretty nice too, but yeah, Scaltrains is. I just wanted to see if this hatch opened. Doesn't. So that's what I got. I got three of these Sioux, the CP Sioux, and the BNSF, and the Ferromax. Five cars in total. And thank you, Joe. I really appreciate it. Thanks for the quick shipping. Thanks for the awesome deal. Yeah, I really appreciate everything you did. I will put a link to Joe's channel in the description. You know Joe from the Black Rock Central. I just did a video tour of his layout while we were at Timonium. And go check out the rest of his channel. He's got some awesome videos. He shows you more stuff about his layout, working on stuff on the layout, working on cars. Go check out Joe's channel if you haven't already subscribed to him. Anyway, over and out. Catches on the rails somewhere.